Derek, another great partner of yours, Ostaco Windows. Bob Barren, thanks very much for being
here. Thank you very much for having us.
So tell us a little bit about your relationship with Ostaco and how that's gone.
Yeah, we've been working with them for quite a few years now. They make a nice product, vinyl windows. So we have a lot of applications where they work in really well. Really like their glass options. Also, this EnerSense window of theirs has got a nice profile on the sash. Sometimes with vinyl windows, they have more of an ornate sash profile, so we really like this contemporary style.
Just more of a simplistic, simplified. And I know on the doors we talked about wood versus vinyl. I frankly am a fan of vinyl. Bob, help us with that. Where's the industry going with that?
This product here is all a vinyl exterior, but the interior is all cellular PVC.
Okay.
So it's all butt joint, so it's going to look and have all the characteristics of a wood window. But it's a maintenance free, and it is in a cloud white finish, so you don't have to do any painting, even though you can.
Right, and that's kind of cool, right? You can match colors if you want, so that's always consideration. I like the characteristics of vinyl just from that durability standpoint, less painting needs, less moisture issues, that kind of idea.
The market's really looking for as little maintenance as possible.
Right. The challenge, of course, for us was triple glazed again, and you've done some great work.
We have. We've developed this one in along with Truth Hardware Cardinal Glass, so it's an 1 3/8 glass unit. Along with Truth Hardware, that hardware was developed to take a true triple glaze.
Isn't that interesting? Like, that's significant.
And there's your difference between a dual glaze rotor gear and this one here.
Wow, like it's significantly
tougher. Correct.
Wow, that's cool. And then in terms of glazing choices, you again work with Cardinal?
We do work with Cardinal, so what we have here is 272 on 272 in a triple glaze. You do have options of 180, 366. There's options also with the I-89s.
So again, matching up the zero energy use. We typically in the zero energy, net zero, in anything but far north, we are sacrificing some of the winter gain to make sure we don't have summer overheat. So the low solar gain, which is also low radiant loss, so we're maintaining good comfort.
Correct.
And then, but still getting excellent summer performance.
Correct.
Great. And then you wanted to show just a little bit the profile to give people a sense of what that triple looks like. Let's just grab that sample.
Let's grab that one. Okay. This is a cross-section of this exact window here. As you can see, it's an all vinyl construction outside. It's 90 to 95 thou walls. So it's designed for triple glaze. And then the inside component is all cellular PVC.
Right. And then those two air spaces.
Half inch air space on each one.
Help us understand that spacer, because there's been huge innovation there.
This spacer bar is a Cardinal spacer bar, which is a stainless steel. So like if you're gonna do a comparison, a stainless steel, if you grab your frying pan, you grab that handle, that's a stainless steel handle.
Okay.
You notice it doesn't transfer that temperature.
Isn't that kind of cool?
Yes, it's great.
And then we're argon filled.
90% argon fill.
90%. Great. So again, that we like that resiliency, that durability of the vinyl construction on the outside, no maintenance to that, and then inside, as you say, totally paintable surface.
Correct.
Very cool.
It is also available. You can also option this one out to have a wood interior as well. So it's exactly the same profiling as the cellular PVC. So you can do it either in a clear pine, cherry, or an oak interior.
And where do you see the industry going? You're probably aware that we're not too far away from everything being triple glazed.
Yes. And bigger and bigger and bigger.
Everybody wants
yes,
more.
Yes, everybody wants bigger. So one of the things with the contemporary windows that are out there as well is all the, instead of having 45s like a typical vinyl window would have, these are all butt jointed together. So it does give you that contemporary look as well.
Right. I always joke that we want more glass. Nobody really wants to be outside. They just want to pretend they're outside.
Yes.
Right? So we're not going back to smaller windows anytime soon.
Not by the looks of things coming through the plant.
Fair enough. And yet, I don't know if you guys are aware, but the goal is by 2030, 2032, all new houses will be net zero qualified or certified. And that almost inevitably means triple glazed glass. Anywhere north of, well, certainly the Canadian border and many parts of the US are getting to triples. And you guys are set up and ready for it.
We've been doing the triple since 2011.
This
It was developed in 2011.
Very nice. And I'm really glad you went back to first principles and found the right way. We know some window manufacturers are struggling with that decision.
Correct.
Trying to do it with existing. It does make for a heavy window, Derek.
Yeah, they're very heavy.
But you're okay with that?
Yep, no problem.
You've been doing triples since?
Probably 10 years or more.
Yeah, so in that same time frame. Is that one of the reasons you've kind of gone to Ostaco?
Yeah, that's one of the reasons for sure.
They have a reliable window that doesn't cause you any grief.
Yeah, they've been very reliable and easy to install, and nice solid frames. The frames are so sturdy, they make it a lot easier for install.
And imagine too, you know, time was you built a such a tight house, you were getting a lot of condensation issues on windows. You probably don't see it anymore.
No, not with a triple glaze, not with those. No, we don't have as many condensation.
I know in 5 years in my house, I think we had condensation on the window once, 5 years, so, and it was just for the morning, so. Very cool. Well, Bob, thanks very much for being here.
Much.
I really appreciate that. Thanks, Derek.